Dr. Xiu-Min Li is director of Center for Integrative Medicine for Allergies and Wellness and professor of Pediatric Allergy and Immunology at Icahn Medical School at Mount Sinai. She obtained her MD degree in Henan School of Chinese Medicine and a master's degree in clinical pediatric immunology from the Graduate School of China Academy of Chinese Medical Sciences, where she was trained in integrative Western and traditional Chinese medicine. She was a visiting scientist at Stanford before completing a postdoctoral fellowship in clinical immunology at the Johns Hopkins School of Medicine Asthma and Allergy Center, and was appointed an instructor there. Then Dr. Li was recruited by the Division of Pediatric Allergy and Immunology at Mount Sinai. She's a sponsor of US FDA-approved clinical studies of investigational new botanical drugs. In addition to the clinical studies, she has established immunobiology and botanical chemistry laboratories with nearly 100 publications. Dr. Li also served in the past as chair of the American Academy of Allergy, Asthma and Immunology, and is an author of the new book, and we'll hear about more about the book in her talk and tomorrow. Welcome and congratulations.
Good afternoon, everyone, friends, colleagues, guests, the new friend, audience. First, I want to thank Renata for providing me this wonderful opportunity. First, I would like to give my disclosure. To address the title of my presentation, I would like to start with this overview about allergy. Allergy, as described by Dr. Prescott, who is an Australian allergist, as a global pandemic of a non-communicable inflammatory disease. The WHO estimates that 40% of the world's population is affected by allergic diseases. It manifests where the body confronts the environment, such as skin, airway, and the digestive system. It perhaps due to the confusion of innate and alert and acquired immune system associated with modern environment changes such as hygiene, diet, microbiome, and epigenetic modification. Western approach include avoiding triggers, corticosteroids, and other medication use such as antihistamine and allergen-specific immunotherapy. However, no conventional cures are on the horizon. We have several ongoing projects, include developing botanical drugs for asthma, food allergy, and anti-IgE products, and in collaboration with a pharmaceutical company and a university in China to develop antigen-specific immunotherapy for food allergy. We mainly focus on peanut allergy. And we also develop natural products for wellness. For today's presentation, to address the title of my presentation, I'll just focus on our research work on developing botanical drugs for asthma and allergies. As you can see, asthma is a serious health problem worldwide, and it has a big burden on individuals and society. And the current treatment is only suboptimally effective. Therefore, we need a better approach. Do we know why, what's happened about the asthma? Yes, over the past years, we have a better understanding about the pathogenesis of allergic asthma. Now we know that asthma is an Th2 skewed immune disorder, meaning that too much Th2, too little Th1, they just cannot keep balanced immune homeostasis. You can see at least the three pathways lead to asthmatic airway hyperactivity, abbreviation AHR. The first pathway is allergen, IgE, mast cell mediated acute reaction, such as if a child who is allergic to a dog, if he exposed to a dog, he will have acute wheezing. Second is IL-5 eosinophil mediated chronic inflammation. In the recent years, more studies demonstrated that neutrophils also contribute to chronic inflammation. And is this the third pathway, the inflammation that the patients who are not responded to current corticosteroids treatment? You can see asthma is a heterogeneous airway disease, therefore more personalized the treatment, and the comprehensive immunomodulatory approaches might be a better approach. We developed a Chinese herbal product named ASHMI, stands for Anti-Asthma Herbal Medicine Intervention, derived from a traditional Chinese medicine formula that has been used in China, Japan, Friendship Hospital for treating childhood asthma. We have made some progress over the past years as summarized in this slide. Number one, in clinical trials, we conducted several clinical studies and found that this product is safe and well-tolerated in adults and in children. And we also generated a preliminary efficacy and showing that this product can be used as a standalone or in combination with current inhaled corticosteroids. Now, number two, in mouse model of asthma, scientists like to use animal models because you can take a close look of immunological changes, inflammation that cannot be done easily in human. So in animal model, what we found that asthma has a broad and long-term benefit in both eosinophil and neutrophil predominant asthma, and the increased airway smooth muscle relaxation. And interestingly, prenatal asthma treatment prevents offspring from developing asthma as an early intervention. Number three, we also conducted the isolation and identification of active compounds that target on asthma major mechanisms. In the following few slides, I'll just show you some representative results relevant to this each aspect. This slide shows one of our clinical studies involved in 91 moderate to severe asthma patients who received ASHMI or oral steroids for 4 weeks. We found that ASHMI had a comparably improved lung function and showing in A, and reduce the beta 2 agonist use versus oral steroids. Then we want to know how ASH may affect the immune system. We look at the effect on IL-5, showing in panel A, which is a Th2 cytokine that is very critical for eosinophilic inflammation. And we also look at the effect on interferon gamma, showing in panel B. Interferon gamma is signature Th1 cytokine that is a protective cytokine in asthma therapy. So what we found is both ASHMI and oral steroid reduce the IL-5, but ASHMI increase the interferon gamma, whereas oral steroid reduce the interferon gamma. Next, we want to know how ASHMI affect serum cortisol level. You know, cortisol is a natural anti-inflammatory steroid released by adrenal gland. So we found that before treatment, showing in the pink bars, both groups had a lower level of cortisol levels. Interestingly, after treatment, ASHMI increased the cortisol levels. You can see bring the level close to, it's in the normal range, whereas oral steroid treatment further reduced the cortisol level. Now, use animal model, we can take a close look of ASHMI and the steroids on the cytokine changes. Here we look at the IL-4, which is another signature Th2 cytokine that initiate a cascade of allergic reactions in bronchoalveolar lavage fluid. And here we mainly want to compare immediate treatment and 8 weeks treatment, what's going on. We found that immediate treatment, both ASHMI and dexamethasone, shown in pink bars, reduce the IL-4. However, 8 weeks post the treatment, while ASHMI continue to suppress IL-4, this effect was declined in oral steroids. Here we use dexamethasone in an experimental model. This slide shows lung histology. You can see here the circles, just give a little bit of orientation, are airways. And this slide shows the 8 weeks post the therapy. In untreated mice, you can see these little dots. They are inflammatory cells around the airway. They stand by H and E, they are purple, blue. And then you can see compared with the normal mice, the airway is very clean. So dexamethasone, which is a steroid, immediate treatment, you know, can clean up the airway. But this 8 weeks post therapy, you can see numerous inflammatory cells retained around the airway. At some point, it appeared even worse than the sham treatment. However, 8 weeks post therapy, the airways in ASHMI treated mice appeared still very clean. So next, we want to understand the active compounds that target on specific critical inflammatory cascade. ASHMI is composed of three herbs. They are safflower, glass rosy, common name licorice, and Ganoderma lucidum, the common name is medicinal mushroom. Use HPLC fingerprint, we are able to characterize the major botanical chemicals in the combination. They are alkaloids, flavonoids, and triterpenoids. So we are able to use the tools like cell lines, animal model, to identify their key biological effect. Here, I just want to use one sample to show you how we identify the active compounds. These are the 15 triterpenoids isolated from the medicinal mushroom. We use the cell line that produce TNF-alpha to screen which compounds are the most effective one. So we found that number 8 is very important, and the name of number 8 is ganoderic acid C1. After we identified this, we confirm this compound in human cells. This is the human PBMCs isolated from asthma patients. we look at the GA-C1 effect on TNF-alpha. We found that when the cells stimulate, showing in figure A, when the cells stimulate with LPS, which is a bacteria component, you can see increase the TNF-alpha compared with the media alone. However, if you add this compound to the culture, only 24 hours, you can see a significant reduction. You know, TNF-alpha is a very powerful pro-inflammatory cytokine that is not only important in asthma, it is very important in other inflammatory conditions such as arthritis, inflammatory bowel disease, even brain inflammation. So we want to understand the mechanism, how this compound modulates TNF-alpha. There is a critical, powerful a master transcription factor named the NF-kappa-B that positively control TNF-alpha. So next we look at, we hypothesize that this compound must affect this master controller. As is shown in B, we found that culture with this compound markedly reduced the LPS induce the TNF-alpha production. You can see almost 80% reduction. Very importantly, this compound did not cause any cell death. You can see the cell viability basically the same. So just give a quick conclusion on this finding. Although steroids and ASHMI both have anti-inflammatory effect, but the ASHMI appeared to have a more beneficial effect and a long-term effect. Now I would like to move to our study on food allergy. Food allergy is a second wave of allergy after asthma and environmental allergy. The prevalence is increasing. Food allergy reactions can be life-threatening. At the present, there are no FDA-approved treatment, avoidance, and the use of rescue medication for anaphylaxis following external exposure is still the mainstream of management. You can see food allergy has a drastic negative effect on children and their families and the society. Therefore, it is very important to develop a safe and effective treatment for food allergy. Now, we also have a good understanding about the immunopathogenesis of food allergy. We know that food allergy is also, like asthma, it's Th2-skewed immune disorder. At least three types of immune cells are involved in the cascade of food allergy-induced anaphylaxis. They are Th2 cells, B cells that produce IgE, and activated mast cells that release histamine and cause the symptoms. We developed an herbal product named the FIF2, stands for Food Allergy Herbal Formula 2. This figure shows HPLC, three-dimensional HPLC fingerprint that has been published in a cover page by Journal of Allergy Immunology. We also identified the two key herbs as displayed here. Here, I would like to just give a quick overview about FIF2. FIF2, composed of nine herbs, is the first generation of FDA-approved botanical IND investigational new drug. It has a high safety profile, long-lasting protection, and a comprehensive anti-allergic immunological responses in food allergic mice, and also showed the beneficial immunomodulatory effect in human clinical studies. Here, I just want to show you an example of FIF2 immunomodulation using murine model of a peanut allergy. We also focus on the three key immune cells. In B cells, we found that FIF2 reduced the IgE, showing in the lower line, you can see the effect lasted 50 weeks post-therapy. and also increase IgG, which is a protective antibody. That means FIV2 is not an overall suppressor. On T cells, we show reduced Th2 and increase interferon gamma. That's an immune modulation. On mast cells, as compared with untreated mice, you can see in the red circle, there are lots of granules. Each granule contains lots of histamine molecules. In compared with untreated mast cells, you can see FIV2 still keep integrity. No degranulated or minimal degranulated mast cells. Consistent with this immune modulation, we found that FIV2 has a persistent protection immune model of a peanut allergy. Here, this slide shows symptom scores. So we use a score system 0, no response. 4 or 5 is near fatal or fatal reactions. First, you see peanut allergic mice without treatment. We give first challenge every 4 or 6 weeks. We give another challenge all the way up to 7 challenges. You can see they have reactions ranging from 2 to 5. In contrast, in FIV2 treated group, mice are well protected all the way up to almost the week 50. We found a similar immunomodulatory effect in human cells. However, we face some difficulties about this FIV2 when we move to clinical trials. One of the problems is that FIV2 has too many pills. Patients cannot keep compliance, therefore affect the outcomes. So our goal is to develop a method to purify the FIV2. We use the 2 methods. One is use a solvent to purify the whole formula, and the second is to isolate the compounds, active compounds. We already completed this process, and now we have a product. First is B52, we use butanol to purify it. And the second, we further improved, we use a combination of B52 and ethyl acetate. Ethyl acetate is a great solvent that normally used for coffee and the tea leaves decaffeination. So it's very safe for this process. And now you can see, if old FIV2 first generation patient have to take 36 pills, too much. And now we only need 6 capsules. And we already submitted an FDA IND for clinical study. Here, just briefly show you an idea how potent this purified compound. Compared with the FIV2 showing A, and the B52 showing B, they all reduce IgE. But when you look at IC50, IC50 stands for the 50% inhibition of IgE concentration. In FIV2, we need almost 300. And then in B52, only 32, almost 10 times potent. Now I will move to the last talk. About the regulation of IgE. We have a very strong rationale and passion to develop something anti-IgE molecules, thanks to Barbara's inspiration. Because IgE, you know, is a so critical molecule during initiate anaphylactic reactions, although that's not the only one. And it is a marker of by physicians and families, because what the family do every year, they go to their allergist, they look at the IgE. That's a very important marker. So we have a very strong desire to reduce the IgE. We focus on peanut allergy. Why peanut allergy? Peanut allergy is very persistent. People call lifelong food allergy because patients with peanut allergy rarely outgrown. We also analyzed the data. This retrospective data analysis of a natural course of IgE, almost 2,000 samples. We found that you can see when they are young, their IgE increasing. When they get older, their IgE stay. They will not reduce. But we know 5 to reduce IgE. At my offset clinic, I also see a number of patients peanut IgE or other food IgE reduced. So we are interested in isolate and identify anti-IgE compounds. We isolated two compounds from FIV2, named the laminin and the berberine. And then use a human samples. You see, then we compared their potency. We found that laminin perhaps about 20% reduction, but you look at the berberine, almost eliminated IgE. We also show a very good dose-dependent study in D and no any cytotoxicity showing in. Now, how about the real world? Can Chinese medicine help a patient with a food allergy? So we recently just published a case report. Just let you know my background. I do research. I'm a scientist. I also use traditional Chinese medicine to help patients. So these three cases are extremely severe food allergy patient. You can see the left column coded in the orange yellow color. You can see the first patient within 2 years, she had more than 100 reactions, and then 50% epinephrine use. And you can see the ER visit more than 40 times. And then after treatment, about 1 year, you can see her reactions from more than 100 reduced to one. After 2 years, she has no reactions. And the second patient, before treatment, you see the red yellow color, allergic reaction 30 times. She used 34 times epinephrine because once she has to use 4 times EpiPen because she cannot acquire symptoms and the helicopter lift her to the hospital. And then after treatment, she responded very fast. Within a year, she has no reactions and she passed the challenge. And then the third patient had 400 reactions, basically every day have reactions. This patient is relatively young. You can see his reaction reduced very fast in the 7 to 9 months. He's still continue. So the first patient now entered to the best college in Canada. And then the first patient now is in college. And she just need a maintenance dose of Chinese herbs. And we still keep communication. The second patient passed the challenge, and now just perhaps each summer take 1 or 2 months of Chinese herbs. Now back to our conclusion, to the title of my presentation. What is the answer for the title? My answer is maybe. So I want to thank my colleagues, collaborators, and the families who participate in this study. I also want to thank the funding agents, local organizations, private donations, including Winston Walkoff Fund for Integrative Medicine for Allergies and Wellness. They are here to support me. Thank you very much.